Hey, what's up, everybody? So, what I've got here is called a Midwest Jetster. Back in the 80s, this was a pretty popular kit, and it was considered a ducted fan trainer jet before you actually got it like a scale jet. And this one's got a K&B 3.5, it's got the little tune pipe on it. And, anyways, the kit, when you built the kit, it didn't have functioning rudders. These were just solid sheets of balsa back here. And but I made mine to where they were functional, where you got twin rudders like on a B-25. So, and I've had a guy that he's putting a pulse jet on one of these, and he was asking me how I got my rudders working, and trying to explain it's it would take forever, so I just thought I'd do a quick video to help them out. So let me get this turned over. Okay, so I'll just show the first the elevator servo. I've got a carbon rod, and it just go a direct link to keep any slop and play out. And then the same way the rudder's got a carbon rod, and the carbon rod goes to about right about here, and then from there I've got these. I think back in the day they call them knot rods, or well, here's one right here. It's on my throttle. So it was like this yellow housing, and then had this really small wire, and it's real flexible. And so if you had to get to like a throttle, that was in a weird spot, this cable was would be a good choice. So anyways, this is the type of cable I've got going that connects here. And then what I did, I routed out a little groove in the horizontal stab to lay that housing down in, and then put a layer of glue over it to where it was end up being flush with the stab surface. So you'll see the where it comes in, and then let's see. Yeah, you'll see it loop around and then connect in, and then there's that the wire, and there's the you can kind of see the housing. And then on this one, same type of deal. Here it comes in, it loops around. Now on this one, it's got to go through the vertical stab, because when the servo pulls, it's a pull push, and each one isn't doing opposite, so they're both getting pulled and pushed. So you've got to put the horn on the same sides of the surface. So it's on the on this one, it's on the inside, and this one's on the outside. So let me show you. Here I'll work the servo. So it's got a pretty good amount of movement. Same way this one. And they're pretty stiff when they're not. But anyways, that's so like I said, the wire runs through in the housing, and then right here, then they I've got them connected to the carbon push rod, and I ran wire around it and then soldered it. And I'm not sure if I can get a shot of the inside, but let's see. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna be able to focus. Anyways, that's how I got the working rudders. So I hope it helps anybody that's wants to put twin rudders on one of these Jetsters, because it's a great flying little airplane. And it's kind of get a kick. I fly turbine jets now, so it's kind of fun to get back every once in a while and fire up one of these old ducted fans, because 40 years ago that's all we had. So anyways, catch everybody later. Bye.